Texas Earth Science Data Systems would like to see more scientists, researchers, as well as applications-based users and decision-makers use the wealth of free and open data from NASA Earth Science. To help in this endeavor, we have been creating new resources to provide more intuitive ways to find, use, and visualize the data. In the Learn section on the Earthdata website at earthdata.nasa.gov, we provide a bunch of great resources to help you get started with remote sensing data. These resources include backgrounders, like this What is Remote Sensing?, a resource for those new to satellite or airborne observations. This backgrounder provides information on the types of orbits, the electromagnetic spectrum, the different kinds of sensors that are used, the different resolutions, like spatial, temporal, or spectral, and then lastly, information on data processing and interpretation. Another backgrounder is What is Synthetic Aperture Radar, or SAR, that provides detailed information on SAR frequency and wavelength, polarization, and even interferometric SAR. Now that you have some background information, let's access the data. For users who don't really know where to begin, in our Learn section, we have a Getting Started guide. It provides information on how you can find data with an Earthdata search, use or analyze the data following specific tutorials or data recipes, or visualize the data within the WorldView application. For novice data users, we have data pathfinders on a variety of real-world topics, including agriculture and water resources, biological diversity and ecological forecasting, COVID-19, disasters such as cyclones, earthquakes and volcanoes, and floods, geographic information systems, or GIS, health and air quality, water quality, and wildfires. Data pathfinders provide direct links to commonly used datasets across NASA's Earth Science data collections. About the data includes information on the measurement taken by each of the sensors that are represented in the pathfinder, as well as the spatial and temporal resolution for that particular dataset. This information is useful when determining which data set to use in your research. In each of the specific sections, the Pathfinders also provide a tools for data access and visualization, with a brief introduction to each tool within the Pathfinder. These tools provide different ways of visualizing the data, options for subsetting the data, and options for saving the data in different file formats. One such tool is Earthdata Search. Earthdata Search is a tool for data discovery of NASA's Earth observation data collections. Users, including those without specific knowledge of the data, can search for and get information about each data collection. I can type my keyword directly into the search box, or I can choose from a list of keywords. I can also search by platform, instrument, organization, processing level, and so on. For example, if I know I want MODIS sea surface temperature data, I can type in sea surface temperature to Instruments and select MODIS. Relevant data collections are now shown. You'll notice here with the AquaMODIS instrument, there are near real-time data collections and research quality data collections. Note that the near real-time products have not been created using the best available calibration and ephemeris information, so they should only be used when data latency is not a concern. Let's go to the research quality data. Clicking on a file shows me in what location on Earth the swath and granular are. But maybe I want a specific area or specific time frame. I can search the data files by date and by spatial area. As more information gets put in to the system, the granules are filtered for just that specific area or time frame. With certain data collections, you can preview browse images and download or submit requests for data files. Sometimes with customization, such as choosing specific bands for download or output to a GeoTIFF format. Here we are back at the earthdata.nasa.gov website. Now, if you're familiar with using NASA Earth Science data, another new resource are our data toolkits. Toolkits contain links to data sets, tutorials and data recipes, webinars, feature articles, and data user profiles, as well as so much other useful information. There is not a lot of guidance on which data set might be best or on the resolutions and the like, but there are direct links to data sets in Earth Data Search or at one of the Distributed Active Archive Centers, or DACs. We have toolkits on biological diversity, freshwater availability, and wildfires. NASA Earth Data's wealth of data discovery and data access resources, such as the data pathfinders, data toolkits, backgrounders, and other resources, are designed to help you find, access, and use NASA Earth Science data, which can help in your research or your organization's decision-making process. Come explore earthdata.nasa.gov.